Better a resonant circuit. In the previous video, we have studied the basic theory of series resonant circuit. Now we are going to study the basic theory of parallel resonant circuit. For the case of parallel resonant circuit, can be represented as parallel RLC circuit, as shown here. In this case, the input impedance would be 1 over the input admittance. And the admittance here, it would be the summation of the admittance of the capacitor, and the admittance of the inductor, and the admittance of the resistor. So, this would be 1 over R plus 1 over J omega L plus J omega C. All of this would be to the power minus 1. This is the input impedance of the parallel resonant circuit. For the case of the parallel resonance circuit, the input impedance at the resonance, it would be R, as in the case of the series resonance circuit, but the input impedance would have the shape of bell shape, such that the input impedance would be less than the resonant input impedance if the frequency is less than the resonant frequency or greater than the resonant frequency. So, away from the resonant frequency, the input impedance will decay. The operating bandwidth of the parallel resonant circuit is defined as the frequency band where the input impedance is greater than or equals R over square root 2 or 0.707 multiplied by R. So, if the input impedance is greater than R over square root, we are in the operating bandwidth of the parallel resonant circuit. The input impedance of the parallel resonant circuit can be represented as half multiplied by the voltage over the resonant circuit multiplied by the conjugate of the current, of the total current passing the parallel resonant circuit, which can also be represented as half Z input multiplied by the magnitude of the current square, which can also be represented as half multiplied by the magnitude of the voltage squared over the conjugate of the input impedance. We are going to use the last four, and because the input impedance was the reciprocal of the admittance, or the admittance to power minus 1, so 1 over input impedance equals the admittance, and here we are going to use 1 over the input conjugate, so we are going to replace any j by minus j. Alright, so the power input for the case of parallel resonant circuit can be represented as half the magnitude of the input voltage square multiplied by 1 over R plus J over omega L minus J omega C. Effectively, the first term corresponds to the power losses in the parallel resonant circuit. So the power losses is half V squared over R. On the other hand, the last term corresponds to the stored electric energy, WE, the stored electric energy equals 1 over 4 V squared C. And the stored magnetic energy is actually 1 over 4 multiplied by the magnitude of the current passing through the inductor, IL squared, multiplied by the value of the inductor. Because here, in the case of parallel resonant circuit, the current, the total current, is divided into three parts, one inside the capacitor, one inside the inductor, and the other inside the resistor. So, the stored energy in the inductor is based on the current on the inductor only. And this current on the inductor can be obtained in terms of the potential difference, which is common for all the three elements as 1 over 4 v squared over omega squared L squared. So, v squared over omega squared L squared multiplied by L, we can eliminate this L with L squared. So, it would be 1 over 4 v squared over 1 multiplied by 1 over omega squared L. Okay? Now, we can say that the input power is the power losses plus the time rate or the average time rate of the stored magnetic energy minus the stored electric energy, where 2J omega multiplied by Wm is the average stored magnetic energy for time harmonic signal, and 2J omega multiplied by We is the average stored electric energy for time harmonic signal. Okay. In this case, we can redefine the input impedance as V input multiplied by 2 over the magnitude of I squared, where B input here is B losses plus 2G omega multiplied by Wm minus W. Once again, at the resonance, the stored magnetic energy equals the stored electric energy. This means that omega naught, the frequency at which the stored magnetic energy equals the stored electric energy, it would be omega naught is 1 over square root LC. And at this resonant frequency, the input impedance, it would be V losses over half I squared, which will correspond to the value of R. And in a similar way to the case of series resonant circuit, the quality factor of the parallel resonant circuit would equal the resonant frequency omega naught multiplied by twice the stored magnetic energy over B losses. But replacing the value of the stored magnetic energy and B losses and omega naught, we can say that the quality factor for the case of parallel resonant circuit is R over omega naught L. It should be noted here, this is a reciprocal for the case of the series resonant circuit. In the case of series resonant circuit, it was omega naught L over R. Now, it is R over omega naught L. If we are talking in terms of C, it would be omega naught RC. And according to this, it can be noted that increasing the value of R in the case of parallel resonant circuit will increase the quality factor. Actually, this is the opposite for the case of the series resonance. For the case of the series resonance, decreasing the value of R will increase the quality factor of the resonance circuit. Alright? As we have studied the series resonance circuit by studying the input impedance near the resonance, we are going to do the same steps for parallel resonance circuits. So, the exact form for the input impedance for parallel resonant circuit is Z input is 1 over R plus 1 over J omega L plus J omega C, all of them is to power minus 1. This is the exact form for the input impedance. And the resonant frequency is omega naught is 1 over square root LC, and the quality factor Q naught is omega naught RC. Now we are going to replace omega by omega naught plus delta omega, where delta omega is very small. So we are near the resonant frequency. In this case, 1 over R doesn't depend on omega. 1 over J omega L. So this 1 over J omega naught plus delta omega. Okay. We can take omega naught as a common factor. It would be 1 plus delta omega over omega naught. So, J omega naught multiplied by 1 plus delta omega over omega naught multiplied by L. Actually, if I'm talking about 1 over 1 plus x, where x is very small value compared to 1, it can be approximated as 1 minus x. So 1 plus delta omega over omega naught in the denominator can be replaced in the numerator by 1 minus delta omega over omega. Here the remaining part is j omega c. J omega c can be replaced by j omega naught c plus j delta omega c. Now at resonant frequency, omega naught is 1 over square root LC. So 1 over j omega naught L plus j omega naught C, this equals 0. If we are replacing omega naught by 1 over square root LC, the remaining part is minus delta omega over omega naught over j omega naught L. And we can take this j from the denominator to the numerator as minus j, so this would be j delta omega over omega naught multiplied by omega naught delta omega over omega naught squared L. And this term has been included in 1 over j omega naught L. The remaining part is j delta omega c. Okay? Alright. Now, this term is 1 over r, this term is delta omega over omega naught squared, and this term is delta omega. Actually, delta omega is very small compared to omega naught, so it is very, very small compared to omega naught squared. So, we can ignore this term. So, approximately, we can say that z input is nearly 1 over r plus j 2j delta omega c. J 2j delta omega c. No. In this case, we have replaced omega naught squared by 1 over LC. Yeah. We have not ignored this term. We have replaced omega naught squared by 1 over square root LC. Omega naught squared has been replaced by 1 over LC. Okay? So this 1 over LC multiplied by L. So it would be 1 over c. 1 over c, the denominator of the denominator, it would be the numerator, so it would be j delta omega c. And already we have j delta omega c. So these two terms together are 2j delta omega c. Okay? So the input impedance near the resonance for the case of barrier RLC circuit is approximately 1 over r plus 2j delta omega c to the power minus 1. So this is the denominator of something. We can arrange it as r over 1 plus 2j delta omega multiplied by r. Actually, all what we have done, we have r is a common denominator, and this actually is to power minus 1. So we have replaced or make r in the numerator and the remaining part in the denominator. So this is r over 1 plus 2j delta omega rc. And already we know that q naught is omega naught rc. So we can replace the value of rc by q naught over omega naught. This means that the input impedance it would be r over 1 plus 2j q naught delta omega over omega naught. This is the input impedance of barrel resonant circuit near the resonance. The question now is how to calculate the operating bandwidth from this equation. The operating bandwidth would be defined as the input impedance Z input, it would be R over 1 plus J1. So, in this case, the operating bandwidth is 2 delta omega over omega naught. The operating bandwidth is 2 delta omega over omega naught. This is the operating bandwidth. So, to obtain the operating bandwidth, the value of bandwidths multiplied by Q naught should be unique. This means that Q naught multiplied by the bandwidth should equal 1, or in other words, the bandwidth is 1 over Q naught. And actually, either for resonant series resonant circuit or very resonant circuit, the bandwidth is 1 over Q naught. And within this bandwidth, the input impedance is greater than or equals R squared, the modulus of the input impedance squared is greater than or equal R squared over 2. At the resonance, it equals R2, right? Also, if we are going to use a complex frequency, we can replace omega naught by omega naught multiplied by 1 plus J over 2Q. In this case, the input impedance can be represented in terms of the capacitor only, for the case of the parallel resonant circuit, as 1 over J2C multiplied by omega minus omega naught. If we are replacing the value of omega naught here by complex omega naught, which is omega naught multiplied by 1 plus J over 2Q naught, we will find out that the input impedance would be exactly the same as this value. Alright? Okay. This is about fractional bandwidth of the barrier resonators. Actually, we are not going to use the resonator separately. We are going to connect the resonator by load impedance, which has a resistance R load. So, in this case, this load resistance will have effect on the quality factor of the resonant circuit. So, we are going to define external quality factor, and this external quality factor for the case of series resonant circuit, it would be omega naught L over RL. For the case of parallel resonant circuit, it would be RL over omega naught L. And the total quality factor of the circuit, of the resonant circuit, after adding the load, it is given by 1 over the loaded quality factor, or the total quality factor is 1 over the external quality factor plus 1 over the unloaded quality factor. Actually, the quality factor which we has already proved, which we have already proved, is the unloaded quality factor. The resonant circuit without any load. So, we are going to calculate the quality factor due to the external, or the external quality factor due to the load resistance. And from the external quality factor and the unloaded quality factor, we can obtain the loaded quality factor of the resonant circuit. And according to the loaded quality factor of the resonant circuit, we are going to determine the bandwidth in the case of loading. In summary, we can summarize all the relations that we have driven for the series and parallel resonant circuit as follows. The input impedance for the series resonant circuit is given by RL plus J omega L minus J over omega C. For the parallel resonator, the input admittance is 1 over R plus J omega C minus J over omega L. Near the resonant frequency, the input impedance for the series resonator can be approximated as R plus J multiplied by 2R multiplied by the unloaded quality factor Q naught multiplied by delta omega over omega naught. For the case of parallel resonator, the input admittance near the resonance, it can be obtained as 1 over R plus J multiplied by 2 multiplied by the unloaded quality factor Q naught multiplied by delta omega over R omega naught. The power losses for the series resonator is half multiplied by the magnitude of the total current I squared multiplied by R. For the case of parallel resonator, the power losses is half the voltage square the magnitude of the voltage squared over the resonant circuit over R. For the case of the series resonance, the stored magnetic energy is 1 over 4 the magnitude of the current squared multiplied by L. For the case of parallel resonator, the stored magnetic energy is 1 over 4 the magnitude of the voltage squared over omega squared L. The stored electric energy for the case of series resonant circuit is 1 over 4 the magnitude of the current squared over omega squared C. For the case of parallel resonator, the stored electric energy is 1 over 4 the magnitude of the voltage squared C. It should be noted here, for the parallel resonator, the common factor is V. For the series resonator, the common factor is R. The resonant circuit for both series and parallel resonators, omega naught is 1 over square root LC. The unloaded quality factor for the series resonator is omega naught L over R, which is 1 over omega naught RC. For the case of parallel resonator, the quality factor is omega naught RC, which is the reciprocal for the series resonator, which is R over omega naught L, which is also the reciprocal of the series resonator. And as I mentioned, for the series resonator, if R is increased, the quality factor is decreased. But for the parallel resonator, if R is increased, the quality factor is increased. This is unloaded quality factor. The external quality factor for the series resonator is omega naught L over RL, where RL is the resistance of the load connected to the resonator. For the case of parallel resonator, the external quality factor is RL over omega naught L, which is the reciprocal for the case of the series resonator. The total quality factor is given by 1 over Q total equal 1 over Q naught plus 1 over QE. This is the summary of series and parallel resonant circuits. Actually, this is a basic theory of the series and parallel resonant circuits. It is valid for microwave or lower frequency circuits. But we are going to apply this theory starting from the next video to the case of microwave resonators.